Hey everybody, welcome back to another episode of Benji's Logs and Adventures. Thanks for clicking on the video. Hope everyone's having a fantastic day or night, depending on where you guys are in the world, time you guys watching this video. As you guys have guessed, it is a rainy day today, but that's okay. I don't need to be outside on this afternoon because we have one of our little packages come in this afternoon that we've been waiting eagerly for. But what could it be? What could it be? And there it is, right there. Most of that is empty. The parcel is right there. But yet, what could it be? So, without further ado, guys, let's get this cracking open and see what's inside. Right. So one thing I always loved is being able to open these bad boys up when it comes in. Yeah, wonder what it could be. There it is. It is an SD laser. Probably going to be back to front for you guys. SD laser 303. What sort of batteries it takes. Looks like I might just take some double A's. Sweet, got plenty of those. Interchangeable lens. Size for a double A, which I've got some sitting just over there. So give me a second, I'll grab some fresh batteries for it. Well, that's a kind of a bummer, guys. I just tried me batteries in this thing, but looks like it needs a specific sort of battery, which is a little bit bigger than I expected it to be. Because the double A battery doesn't quite sit in it properly, so it's I'm gonna have to go down to the shops at an eventual time and get a battery or a couple of batteries. It's kind of cool because it's got this little lock on the back. So it kind of engages and disengages the ability to use it, which is cool, because I can take the keys away, turn it off, leave it sitting somewhere, and it won't be used for any malevolent style thing. So it's kind of cool, but at the same time it kind of sucks, because yeah, I was kind of hoping the AA batteries would work, because that's the size comparison right there. So it needs to be at least double the size. So I'm going to have to go and have a look at some of the shops tomorrow or online and see if I can find something for it. But with a little bit of luck, guys, I realise that I do have another piece of equipment that does use very similar batteries that we need. We have the batteries that we need to run the laser pointer, guys, or the laser grid, as I like to call it. All I needed was the CR123A battery, which is about half the size of the AA batteries but twice as thick. So what we can do is we can now run our little laser grid. So what we can do is we can take the center piece off like so, plunk that in there, take the end piece that has the most important part of the whole thing, twist this onto there like so, and here's the moment of truth, guys. Bam. Ooh, don't lock up in there. There it is. Laser grid works. That is insane. I'm very happy with that, guys. I'm super duper happy. And not only that, I do have a spare battery for it now, so we can either run two batteries through it if we wanted to, or just the one, which I think we're just going to run the one through it at this point. So what we're going to do now is we're going to turn the lights off, see if it looks like in the dark, but I don't know how well this camera's going to go, because it doesn't like the low light, no light situation, so we'll do this just quickly as possible. That's what it looks like, guys. That is trippy as. I am going to have so much fun with this when the time comes for it. That is absolutely amazing. Kind of cool because you can change it around quite a lot. Goes many different ways. I reckon I'll probably have it sitting like that most of the time, like that. Just gonna have a quick gander what that looks like in the camera. Yep, I'm happy with that. I'm very happy with that, guys. Only downfall with it though, guys, is that is only just a single push down and hold down. Once you let it go, it basically turns the whole lot off. So I'm gonna have to figure out how to hold that button down when I want it to. I might have to get like a little stand that you can put it in. I didn't think about getting a stand for it or getting the bundle that you can get on eBay, but I'm thoroughly impressed that this actually came first above all other deliveries that we had coming in, because we had a couple coming in from other places of the world, but because of the current situation, it makes it a bit hard for them to come in. So I'm thoroughly impressed with that. And I'm thoroughly impressed with this little feature at the back with the keys. So if I wasn't much clear, it doesn't work if it's on the red. Turn the key and it works. That is cool. That is absolutely amazing. But then again, people could potentially able to hijack that and manipulate it in the way that they want, however they want. Your point is an elephant. And we may just have had probably not the greatest idea in the world, but we may just have found a way to keep it on. If we can find the sweet spot. Look at that. No hands. It's just an improvisation at this point. It's just a piece of paper up the top with a key ring. I just move it to a certain spot and it should just turn on and off when we need it. But that's just a temporary thing, because I was initially thinking of using a paddle pop, you know, the little wooden things that you get in your popsicles. I was thinking of just using one of those as a stick it between the key ring and the button, and potentially use that as the on and off button when we need it, because at least that way, if you really wanted to run the paddle pop along the back, have the keyring back here, have it on the button, and as soon as you slide it up like that, it'd turn the thing on. But because this does all right for now, then that's what we're going to be using for the time being. So I'm thoroughly impressed with that. I had the idea as soon as I turned the camera off, it's like, ooh, why not we use a keyring and something in between the keyring and the button? And that's basically what I come up with in a matter of a few minutes. So I'm happy with that. That's going to go in my little box that I showed you guys in the last video, or a couple of videos back, depending on when I release this video. But I'm thoroughly impressed that this has come in, and I must admit it is reasonably bright, so I'm very happy with that. I think I'm going to keep that as it is. I'm not going to remove that, because that will be used for temporary thing. And with the remaining parts that we've got, the battery and the extra little bit that goes there, we'll just chuck that in a loose little spot in the very box that we've got everything else in, so that will go down well. Alrighty guys, I'm going to start concluding this video. I just wanted to quickly put a video out there about packages that we're getting. My theory was correct. I knew this one was going to come quicker than the three ones that I ordered online. This one is the fourth one being ordered online. So I ordered this one 3 weeks after the fact. 3 weeks after the ones that I put in originally, and this one came within 2 weeks of order. So this one came from the UK, and the other ones are coming from somewhere in China at this point, but they keep pushing it back, but we'll see how it goes. I'm going to give them a chance to get it out there and here, because I did order it from Wish, but this may just be the very last time. First and last time I'm using this particular program, so I'll definitely going to be sticking to eBay, something that I know, because well, that's just proof right there that eBay is more reliable to get things out to me as quick as possible considering the current situation. There is one more device that I have coming from the US, from our very good friend Josh from Southern Afterlife Paranormal. I will be showing you guys that on this channel. I am looking forward to using it, that is for sure. I will be getting a new case sometime this week to put that into it to protect it, and some other pieces of equipment that we've got floating around. So as you guys will remember in the last video, a couple of videos back depending, with all the other little pieces of equipment that we've got, that's going to go into there, and then I'm going to use another case to put this other device in that, and a couple of other things. But anyways, I'm sitting here blubbing on it, flapping my gums as per usual, so I'm going to let you guys go. Until the next time, guys, keep it easy.